come to this class. So we're going to paint this Christmas stocking, and I'm going to use similar colors that we see in the reference image. I'm going to start from with it's this face here of the snowman, and this is going to be like small pieces at a time, which is much easier because then we can just kind of break it down into elements and we don't have to like wet the whole thing all at once. So the first thing I'm going to do is wet the face, and we can wet the eyes too, it doesn't matter. And then we can even go through the nose, over the nose, because nose is going to be orange and the eyes are going to be black. So we're just going to focus on shading the face. We're going to use a little bit of blue, we're going to use some yellow, and then a little bit of red. So primary colors, blue, red, yellow. Please don't worry about matching colors, it's not that important. We can use different colors, as long as, let's say, you use yellow, blue, red. So I'm going to wet it first. I'm going to grab my rounded golden one. So this is my rounded gold one. And you can definitely use, let's say, wax stick for the highlights over the eyes. It might be actually easier. So if you have like a wax stick, something like this, this is candle, you can press very gently on the paper there where you have the eyes just to create some highlights in there. We can do the same thing over the nose, a couple ears on the left side for some highlights. And then I think that's pretty much it. So now I'm going to wet the snowman, and if you don't have a wax stick, please don't worry about it. You can use masking fluid, or you can just omit that area when we get to the eyes, for example, or the nose, so the carrot nose. For now, I'm just wetting the paper here. This is my round 8 golden one brush, so I'm using the pointy part to spread the water. There we go. These are small elements. I didn't even pre-dilute my colors with water. It is always easier to have, actually I do have some already. So this is pro red. I have imidazolam yellow. I have a little bit of rosy in here, phthalo blue. Maybe I'll use some Van Dyke brown and then quin red here. So I guess some colors are diluted and some colors are not. But for the face, I'm going to gently grab a little bit of this rosy, tiny bit of that quinacridone red, and I'm gonna go towards like the areas where I feel like I see a little bit of yellow. I'm gonna clean the brush, wipe it slightly on a towel, and just work with those colors. This is just a damp brush spreading some paint, right? And now I'm going to go back, grab some more of this, but also some of the phthalo blue. So quin red, phthalo blue. It feels like this is the bluish area, but for now it's just a blue violet. And I'm gonna add a little bit here too, just to add some color to it. And I'm gonna clean my brush, wipe on a towel, and then I'm gonna go all the way towards the edges and kind of spread the paint a little bit, go in circles with that brush. There you go. Perfect. Okay, I'm gonna grab a little bit of phthalo blue with the tip of my brush and tiny bit of quin red. So it's mostly just the phthalo blue. So just like we see, there's a little bit of blue on the left side. I think it's a great idea to add a little bit to in our painting as well. Tiny. You might as well, like, if you don't feel comfortable using a larger brush, let's say grab a smaller brush for this. And then with the tip of my brush, I'm gonna add blue around those eyes as well. Or add the blue around those eyes. Right here we have the eyes, and then kind of like I'm following what I see in the reference. Whenever I see a little bit of blue, I'm adding some blue. I'm gonna slightly remove a little bit of the paint because it was a little too much. And I'm just gonna grab a little bit of quin red, more of the quin red. Go around the face. It's very gentle, like shading, basically. I'm filling it out. and add a little bit of that red here. This is just a quinacridone red.